Hello guys, today I wanted to show how to control your embedded device over TCP in C and C++ programs. You can go to my GitHub page and clone the project you need, but I suggest you to code by yourself and use source codes only as a reference. Robot server is a C++ version of the server program. Robot control GUI is a client desktop application. And robot server C is a C version of the server program. In the README file, you can find dependencies which should be installed before compiling. First, let me show you C version of the server program, then we will look through C++ version, and then we will look through desktop application. In the C version, as you can see, we have three files: main.c contains TCP connection, mygpio.c, and h files contains GPIO control functions. In the beginning of main C file, we have three socket control includes. Socket.h contains socket functions. IN.h, which stands for internet.h, contains socket structures. And IP.h contains address types. In the main function, first we need to create socket file descriptors and connection file descriptors. Then we need to create socket address server and client addresses, and initialize the server address. AF INET means IPv4 protocol. For port and address members, we have to use H2NS and H2NL functions, which are converting functions. We're gonna use port 1000, and we're gonna use an address any, which means that any address will be connected, could be connected to our server. Our init function initialize GPIO for module control, so you can just comment that. Socket function create socket file descriptor. As you can see, we use IPv4 protocol as well, and socket stream, which means TCP connection. And then we bind our socket with the server address. After that, we can start to listen using our file descriptor. As you know, to establish a reliable connection, TCP requires a triple handshake, which is done by the accept function. And finally, to receive messages, we will use read function, which is actually a wrapper for socket standard receive function. And as you can see in this function, we use connection file descriptor, not the socket file descriptor. After we got our message, we parsing the content, make some moves, and clean the buffer. At the end, don't forget to close the socket. If you compile and run this program, you will see something like this. This means everything is okay and you can start client application. Now let's have a look on the C++ version. There are three files as well, but with a little bit different names. For C++ version, we are going to use boost.asio library. In TCP read function, I'm using streambuf class and data method to get the message from the socket. Robot GPIO class and init method I use to control robot movement, so you can comment that. IaaS service class is the main class we are going to use to initialize acceptor and socket classes. As you can see, we initialize this class with TCPv4, which is IPv4 port number 1000, and without specifying the client's address. Then we create socket class instance, which we are going to use to read messages. And finally, we use accept method of the acceptor class to accept the incoming connection. In the while loop, we read the message, we check this message on emptiness, we parse it, and we do some moves. At the end of the program, we release GPIO lines, but you can comment that function. Also notice that socket will be released automatically. If you want, you can change GPIO lines in the robot GPIO CPP file. As you saw in main CPP file, there is no console messages, but it will print incoming messages. Now let's have a look at the desktop client application. First, open CMakeList file and add network as a package and a library module. To handle TCP connection, we are going to need QTCP socket and QAbstract socket classes. In the TCP socket class, DoConnect and write methods are essential to handle TCP connection. In the DoConnect method, we're creating an instance of QTCP socket class and we're connecting signals to this class. Then we're trying to connect to our server using IP address and the port number. If we were not able to connect to the server in 5 seconds, it will throw an error to the console. Now let's start the application. When you push the button, it will send 2 letters to the TCP server. Here we got 4 messages because we have 2 signals on each button when it's pressed and when it's released. And as I said before, if you close the window binded with C++ version of the server will release sockets automatically. And that is how you control your embedded device using TCP in C and C++ programs. If you want to know more, you can find additional links in the description. That's it, guys. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.